This is the next question we have, which is question number 33 from code G and question number 36 from code H. It says, list 1 contains properties and list 2 contains order. Match properties in list 1 with their correct order list 2. So we have these 4 properties, number of unpaired electrons, number of d-pi p-pi bond, electron affinity and covalent character. Students, यहाँ पर हम देख सकते हैं कि number of unpaired electrons that must be compared in O2, O2 minus, O2 2 minus. Why? Because if I talk about electron affinity, that is for atoms, covalent character, that should not be for these molecules. So the number of unpaired electrons must be this comparison. Also, if I talk about O2, O2 contains 2 unpaired electrons in its antibonding pi orbitals. O2 minus contains only 1 unpaired electron in its antibonding pi orbital. O2 2 minus contain no unpaired electrons. So this is the correct order given, and we can say P matches with 4. Now if I talk about the second case, number of d pi p pi bond. As we know, P4 O10 contains 4 pi bonds in which we have P double bond O. Here p pi d pi bond is formed. There are 4 p pi d pi bonds formed in P4O10. If I talk about SO3, SO3 has sulfur with sp2 hybridization, so 2 e orbitals are involved in the hybridization. We have only 1 p pi p pi bond, and other 2 pi bonds will be p pi d pi. So P4O10 will have 4 p pi d pi bond, SO3 will have 2 p pi d pi bond, and if I talk about SO2, it will have 1 p pi d pi bond. So the correct answer, that is Q, matches with option 1 from list 2. If I talk about electron affinity decreases down the group. However, because of smaller size, oxygen has least electron affinity in its group. So R matches with 2. If I talk about covalent character, as the size increases, ionic character increases. Hence, covalent character decreases as per the Fajans rule. So smaller the cation, larger will be the covalent character as per the Fajans rule. Hence, this is the correct order for covalent character, and we will say S matches with 3. So P4, Q1, R2, S3. Let's check through the option. P4, Q1, R2, S3. So option C will be the correct answer. Now let's move to the next question. So this is the next question we have, which is question number 34 from code G and question number 35 from code H. It says list 1 contains some molecules or ions, while list 2 contains hybridization of central atoms. Match list 1 with list 2. If I talk about NSiH3 whole thrice, here silicon will have hybridization sp3. On the other hand, nitrogen will have hybridization sp2. Why? Because of the back bonding. Silicon contains vacant d orbital. Nitrogen has a lone pair. Now if we consider this lone pair, this will give us sp3 hybridization. But this lone pair is involved in back bonding. That's why the hybridization will be sp2. So here sp2, sp3 will be the correct match, and which is given in option 2. So we will say P matches with 2. If I talk about NO2 plus and NO3 minus, which is in N2O5. NO2 plus will have hybridization of nitrogen as sp. Here the hybridization will be sp2. So Q matches with 3. If I talk about NCH3 whole thrice, in this case carbon will have hybridization sp3 because it has 4 bond pairs. If I talk about nitrogen, it will have 1 lone pair and 3 bond pairs. So it will have hybridization sp3. There is no back bonding involved here because carbon does not have any vacant d or p orbital. So sp3 and sp3, hence R will match with option 1. If I talk about last case, that is PCl6 negative and PCl4 positive. The hybridization here for phosphorus is sp3d2. In this case, hybridization is sp3. So sp3d2 and sp3, That's option 4. So S matches with option 4. So T2, Q3, R1, S4. We have T2, Q3, R1, S4. So the correct answer for this question is option D. Now let's move to the next question. So this is the next question we have, which is question number 35 from code G and question number 34 from code H. It says match list 1 with list 2. List 1 has few compounds and here some of the properties are mentioned. Let's talk about BF3. If I talk about BF3, BF3 will have geometry or trigonal planar shape. The net dipole moment is 0. So it is planar but non-polar. So the P matches with non-polar planar, that is 4. If I talk about N3H, it is planar but it is polar. So it is polar and planar. So Q matches with 2. If I talk about NS3, NS3 has trigonal pyramidal structure. So trigonal pyramidal structure means it will have some dipole moment and it is non-planar also. So it is polar but non-planar. So it matches with 3, that is polar and non-planar. So R matches with 3, polar and non-planar. If I talk about SF6, SF6 will have octahedral geometry. It does not have distorted octahedral shape. It has octahedral shape. So if I talk about SF6, all the bonds are identical and they are at equal angle from each other. So SF6 will have non-planar shape and it has zero dipole moment. So it is non-polar and non-planar. So SF6, that is S, matches with 5. P4, Q2, R3, S5. That is option A. So the correct answer for question number 35 is option A. Now let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have, which is question number 36 from code G and question number 33 from code H. This says radius of first orbit of hydrogen atom is A0 and energy of electron in first orbit of hydrogen atom is minus E0. On this basis of information, select the correct match in list 1 with list 2. So this is the radius of first orbit of hydrogen atom. This is the energy of first orbit of hydrogen atom. So we can calculate the radius of fourth orbit of Be3+. So P has radius of fourth Bohr orbit will be equal to A0 N square by Z. So this will be equal to 4 times of A0. I'm talking about P option. If I'm talking about Q option, it says energy of electron in second orbit of He+. If I talk about energy of second orbit of He+, it will be equal to minus E0 Z square, that is 2 square by N square, that is 2 square. It is equals to minus E0. So that is Q. If I talk about R, separation energy of electron in third orbit of He+ ion. Third orbit of He+ ion, separation energy of third orbit will be equal to what? Plus E0 Z square by N square. That will be equal to 4 by 9 times of E0. If I talk about S, it says separation energy of electron in second orbit of Li2+ ion. Separation energy of second orbit will be equal to plus E0. Li2+ will have Z equal to 3. Here N is 2. So Z square by N square, that will be equal to 9 by 4 times of E0. So here P is 4A0, that is 2. If I talk about Q, it is minus E0, that is 1. If I talk about R, that is 4 by 9 E0, that is 4. If I talk about S, it is 9 by 4 times of E0, that is 3. So 2, 1, 4, 3. That is option B. So the correct answer for this question 36 will be option B. So students, this is all about AITS Test 1A, Paper 1 and Paper 2. All the very best. Thank you.